Welcome. This is Mr. Travis 779. I have a new project to work on. This is my grandma's 1986. I think it's an 86. It's either 86 or an 86.5. Not exactly sure. But when we get the title, we'll take a look at it. The 1986 Nissan Hardbody. She owned it since it was new. She's had this since she bought it brand new in 86. As you can see, it's been mostly a work truck. It's got some dents and dings that I'm going to have to tear apart. The bumper's destroyed. And license plate is original. Old California plate. Of course, that will be changed. Does have a bed liner in it, which I have never taken off, and I don't know how to take off. It did have a paint job on it at one time, but since then the paint's been, it was kind of a cheap job that was done on it. As you can see, it was kind of a cheap job. They didn't prime it right, they just sprayed right over it. This fender looks fine. This fender here needs to be redone. And you can see the blue color. It was this blue color, now it's... And then she had it repainted at one time. But this is the project. This has been in the family since it was new, like I said, back in 86. I actually honestly don't know very much about it. I have driven it several times. When I used to go down to California to visit, I drove it off and on here and there. But other than that, I really don't know too much about it. I know it's had tons of work done to it over the years. It's had tons of small work, small things done. Pop the hood here. It does not have the original engine. The old engine actually, it was a long story. It was back in the early 90s. She had the oil changed. Excuse me, guys. She had the oil changed, and they didn't tighten up the oil. Something wasn't tightened up quite good enough, and it went everywhere, and so the motor blew up. So this motor probably actually has less than, oh gosh, I would say probably 88,000 miles on it, 990,000, almost 100,000. As you can see, she's put a new clutch fan, water pump. This does have air conditioning. It currently does not work, which I'll fix that. I don't know what exactly the issue is at the moment. Had a new master cylinder put on it at one time. Of course, this is a California truck, so it's got all the emissions equipment on it. And to be honest, I don't know if the air conditioner even has anything in it. The distributor cap's been changed. It's got the Z24 engine in it. Nissan Z, so it's got the Z motor in it. The battery's kind of old. And all this needs to be cleaned up and redone. I don't know. This is broken. That happened a long time ago. This is the EFI motor, so I don't know if this is the rear AC, or the Z24i for injected, or the Z24. I have to do research. And also, I heard that it was a, if you guys are out there, or anyone who knows about these trucks, I believe this is an 86.5, I want to say. I'm not sure, though. If it's, I want to say it's an 86.5. Because I remember correctly, I think these were changed. These came out in 86 as 86.5s, but I'm not sure. I'm going to get the title, and I'll see what the title actually says. I know it's an 86 something. All right, got the clutch master cylinder. This is the emission stuff. It does have California emissions. Looks like they changed the radiator in it. Radiator's been changed. Very strong clamps. Fuel filters right there. That's been changed. It does run actually quite well. It actually does run well. No power steering. Of course, it doesn't have power steering on it. But it actually does run quite well. And like I said, the emissions, see, this is 1030. Freezing, 1030 weight motor oil. I don't know. This is the timing mark, 0.5. Idle speed, 650 RPM. 5 top dead center. Idle mixture screw is preset and sealed at the factory. TBII, 145.8 cubic inches, 2.4 liter. It says here, this vehicle conformed to USA 1986 model year vehicle. Mission Control, Nissan Motor Company. I don't know where the air conditioner stuff is. I don't know how, according to my antifreeze coolant. I mean, I don't really know too much. Like I said, I drove this truck a few times, but not very much. You can see all their... See, she did a paint job, but see, they didn't really... Well, they actually... No, they didn't. They didn't put it inside the door jams. See, if you can look, they stopped the door jams. Let's see what this says on the side here. If I can see it here. Nissan Motor Company. Ooh, sounds like some birds are fighting. Look at that. Ooh, that guy's... That birdie's mad. Let's see. Says 4 of 86. Right there, 486. I don't know if you guys can tell the code on this. This vehicle conforms to all application federal motor safety shown in the above manufactured date. That just tells a bunch of tire stuff, really. It's got a whole bunch of stuff in the back. Pretty dirty. It's pretty dirty. It's gonna need to be completely and totally redone. I'll start it up here for you guys. It actually has a bad clutch in it, so I can't really drive it at the moment. I gotta work on the clutch. And here the pump. But it does fire. And it actually sounds quite good. A little slow starting, could need a battery. really filthy. It came from a canyon over in California, so it's been there all its life. But it's little filthy. A little dirty. Clean all this out. We'll probably power wash the whole thing. This is a spare tire. Take this out. Keep that in there for right now. Clean it off. See, they sprayed it. I never noticed this before either. They sprayed it. They must not have sprayed on it. I bet you they didn't take this off. Almost $1 million they didn't take this off. This came stock with this on. Dents here I gotta take out. I'm not sure how. Not sure how. Oh, I guess it just lifts off. Okay. It slips off. Anyways, this is it. This will be our next project. I'm going to do the clutch on it. I mean, it sounds good. It sounds fine. I mean, I know my grandma has done tons of work to it. Done an extraordinary amount of work. Look at it's got a busted vacuum. Vacuum holes. Now there's two vacuum line holes. No idea where that goes. There are two vacuum lines that are need to be done. I just noticed that. Got another vacuum. Supposed to have two of them. It's got two coils. It's running a little rough, but to be honest, I just noticed. There, see, it's got a vacuum link. See, when I block it off, it smooths out. So we gotta fix that. I don't even know what that even is, too. Had a... Oh, there it is, right there. On a control something. It looks like that's got to get hooked up. So we'll have to fix that. Okay. We'll have to go through and fix that. But I might even have some. Get in the garage. But anyways, that's what it is. Let's go ahead and shut this. We'll go ahead and shut it off. It's cozy enough. What else can I tell you in here? We're gonna clean up the dash, change all that, clean all this up, make it look pretty. I don't know if of course, no power steering. Horn still works. Heat, and this, like I said, this did have air conditioning, and I remember it working. It worked pretty good. That's not what you think it is. That's my uncle's Sage. I don't ask me why. It's got some holes. got some, here's the original, there's the original door handle, here's the original book, 1986 Nissan Owner's Manual. See what we got here. This is Nissan original owner's original enclosures documents. It's probably been in there for 20 years. What's this? I mean, my grandma's always kept things very, very good. Must be roadside assistance stuff. Of course, there is no registration in here. Grandma does have the title to it, so we'll make sure we grab that. What is this? I don't know what this is. Must be to the stereo. It did have a stock stereo in it, but they changed out the stereo. If I remember correctly, my grandpa long before he passed, my grandpa's passed away now, but he was the one that did the stereo. Let's see if it actually works. Powered up now. Yeah, I don't know if this works or not. Oh, I guess it does work. The FM. Yeah, piece of junk. It'll get replaced. Along with the speakers will get replaced too. Headliner's original, and it's still in one piece. They never did paint the doors. I'll paint these white. Well, maybe. No, those were never painted, so we'll have to paint. We'll paint the door jam. Here's where they cut the paint in. Look at how they did that. If I remember correctly, my grandma paid like $800 for the paint job. Some California, you get a lot of people painting cars for really cheap prices. And then you go to get the hot rodders who paint cars for thousands of dollars. But let's see what's in the back. Tire jack. I don't know how to take this. Like I said, I don't really know too much about this truck. You can see in the back. Like it's got rope. Too bad. This will get changed into Nissan bucket seats. I don't like that bench seat. I'll get changed into, I believe Pathfinder seats will fit in this. So, actually any seat will fit in this if you customize it right. But anyways, this will be our next project. We'll go through it like we do. Is it a little bit more rougher shape than what the Bronco was? But we'll we'll restore it and repair it and get it back to its former glory. Anyways, this is Mr. Travis, 779, and when I start doing the clutch, we'll look underneath it. I can't crawl under there at the moment, but we'll look underneath it and see what it's going to take to do a clutch on this. I don't think it's going to be too difficult, but we'll see what it takes to do a clutch. This is Mr. Travis, 779.